here I'm talking to Ngong from Vietnam. He's a participant of our conference here in the Dean's Conference. So what are you going to talk about? What is your topic in this conference?
Joining this conference, I'm talking about using KIP, that Key Performance Indicator, to manage my college at Cần Thơ University.
Okay, and so from which university do you come from and what are your experiences there?
I come from Cần Thơ University and at the moment I'm Dean of College of Engineering Technology. I talk about why I joined to this conference. Long time before, under sponsoring of DAID, I was participated in IDC, that's the International Dean course.
Oh.
Yeah. And after finish the IDC training course, I using my personal project to apply to my college.
Oh,
and
great.
Then I use KIP tool to evaluation staff and faculty in my university.
Okay, that's interesting. Can you tell us a little bit more about this personal action plan that you had and what was the final result when you implemented it?
After finish the IDC training course, I developed, I strengthened my strategic plan for the college. And in my strategic plan, I also developed the KIP for manage the college, that every activity of faculty or staff we can measure and we can give credit for any activity of employee. And at the end of the year, we can count how many credits they get, and then we can rank them in our ranking system.
So you would say it was a very useful tool for your university?
Yes, I think. Before using the KIP tool, normally the excellent rank always come to the own person or the person who gets high position in the college, you know. But after using the KPI tool, the result is a little bit different. They move to the young one who involved in research and publication.
Okay.
Yeah, it's really different from the old version in my college.
So would you say that you definitely need these KPIs as an instrument?
Yes, I think it's useful. And so we have to continue to approve our KPI and apply for the new year's school year.
Okay, so last question, what do you think is then the most relevant KPIs?
I think it's useful, but when applies,
Which one specific, just to give us an example, which one is the most relevant?
Yeah, for example, if one young person after graduate PhD, they go back to my college and they do some research, they publish some paper in conference or journal, and they can get higher credits. And of course some other activities, so at the end of the year in evaluation process they can get higher score.
Okay, thank you very much for your contribution.
Okay, you're welcome.